the dormouse.
Now, this is another creature that you're very, very lucky to see. In fact, I've only ever seen one in the wild, and that was in late October on the Norfolk coast, and it was just stuffing his little cheeks with blackberries before hibernating. But just look at that little face. So exquisite.
This little scamp embodies just about all the attributes that we've been looking for in our wild delights. I mean, come on, just look at that. The twitchiest whiskers you ever did see, putting our rabbits to shame. Little pink nose, dark come-to-bed eyes, perfect for peeping out. The dormouse even outdoes the squirrel with its nuts because it eats hazelnuts in a very particular way, leaving a shell with a perfectly round hole so that it leaves little clues as to where it's been, which is very considerate. And that's not all. Just like the hedgehog, it'll help out in the garden. If caterpillars are driving you crazy eating all your plants, worry not, a dormouse can step in. And what, though, is his dark secret? Nothing. After all, he's our number one.
I always think it's such a shame that something so beautiful spends so much of its time in pitch darkness at the top of the trees where nobody can see it. On the other hand, there's something rather sweet about that, isn't there? I mean, be honest. There's only one way of putting it, isn't there? Ah.